Fortune, the Final Frontier. Your host is Robin Leach, who circles the globe to uncover the stories America will never stop talking about. During Hollywood's golden era, the Hotel of the Stars was a second home to its investors Mary Pickford, Douglas Fairbanks, and Louis B. Mayer. They were the first to sink $3 million, a king's ransom in 1927, into the Hollywood Roosevelt Hotel. Here, Clark Gable casually mentioned to the hotel barber he was considering a frivolous little Civil War film, Gone with the Wind. Here, Shirley Temple tapped her way down the lobby stairs with Bill Bojangles Robinson. Because of the memories and its classic location overlooking the world's movie capital, savvy investors shelled out $35 million to restore the Hollywood Roosevelt legend to its former splendor. When it glittered like a precious stone, party time, and in a lavish style that echoed the old days.
Of the evening. If you take a look down there, you see all these, how excited people are. And to me, if that's what you call Hollywood, then it's Hollywood. But I think it's just a freewheeling of people feeling free and open and friendly. Hollywood has that, it's contagious in that sense, you know? I met my first wife here. I don't know if that's good or bad, but I met her here. No, it's good. And I live not far from here. We used to come in here in the lobby on Saturday night, try to pick up some girls and get a sandwich. Things haven't changed much.
Everyone cheered the Roosevelt's swinging return to the big league of superstar hotels. It's one of those places nobody forgets.
When I was a little girl, I used to come here for dinner with my parents, Kathleen and Jean Lockhart. I can remember that when I was in my later teens, the Cine Grill was not spelt C-I-N-E by us. We call it the Sin Grill because of all the action that went on in the bar.
Back then, in the famous Cine Grill, Mary Martin made her singing debut for $35 a week. And when she couldn't find a babysitter for the mite who would become Big Bad J.R., why, she brought him along. The very first Oscar awards were presented in the Roosevelt's Blossom Room in 1929. Little wonder today's stars are more than happy to honor part of their heritage.
It's a lot better than ripping it down and putting up a glass and steel structure. Way we hold on to our heritage and dress it up and make it modern and livable. I think it's a great idea.
They've forgotten me.
They love you, Ariel. They love you.
No, they don't. My last hit was Slip My Wrist, and that was 14 years ago. And that was only because on the day it came out, I actually did slip my wrist.
Trust me, Ariel. They love you.
No, they don't. I don't understand it, Effie. There's been a backlash against anorexic, formerly bisexual ex-junkies.
There hasn't. They love you.
And now, I'd like you to give a big welcome to the I Am a Doormat Girl, Ariel Faber.
All right, baby, go get it, ladies. They love you. Go get it, that's it. Go get it, baby.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. It's good to be back.
We love you.
We love you.
I'd like to do one of my old ones from back when I was institutionalized. Psychotic daytime drama. Take me down to the psychorama.
Oh, I love it!
I ask your teachers to feel to be free. You ask our judges to feel to be me. Pretty colored pills, red and yellow.
Again.
Wonderfulest, greatest guy in the whole world, Dwayne.
Oh, not Dwayne again!
The most beautiful day is today. The most beautiful moment is this.
I feel better.
Right here.
Tonight, a world premiere movie. Barbara Eden's a modern-day Cinderella who's swept off her feet by a Prince Charming.
You don't feel like a society lady.
That's because she's got a secret.
And she's very bullish on corn.
It's a checkout girl's fairy tale fantasy.
You are so beautiful.
And a dream come true.
I've wanted you all my life.
But now her secret is about to be discovered.
You can consider your little fairy tale finished.
Will it all blow away when her prince finds out about the secret life of Kathy McCormick next?
You know, sometimes I think we forget how difficult it is to serve the public, to cater to their every need and still maintain some sense of dignity. It's tough.
Who is that woman?
I have no idea.
I don't understand the first thing about Wall Street.
But my husband loves to dabble in commodities. Any hot market tips?
Oh, shoot. I don't know anything about...
Oh, I wouldn't want you to get in trouble for, inside trading or anything.
When I said the market, I meant... Uh-huh. The market. What looks good to you? Well, corn is looking very good these days.
Yeah.
You're not out on the town?
No, I'm just relaxing in the bosom of my family.
Well, not the whole family. Abby's working late. I checked her schedule.
I was, glancing at the newspaper and saw a response to yesterday's column. You know, the one you left on my desk?
The one that I put on your desk?
Yeah, Ann Landers, the sex survey. Sex is a funny thing, isn't it?
It makes me laugh.
I mean, I think people take sex too seriously sometimes.
I mean, say you or I had an affair.
With whom?
Oh, I don't know.
Each other, let's say. Now, you and I could go to bed together because, well, after all, it's just sex.
Well, some people take it more seriously than that.
Some people. But not everyone. I mean, some people say that going to bed with someone who's married is wrong. But I say it depends on who that someone is.
Would it help to meet the head of Murakami?
Yes. Where did you get the name? Out of a phone book?
Oh, that's a trade secret.
No more secrets.
Does that mean you'll stay?
I love L.A.
And then, there's the problem that married sex can get boring. I mean, it says right here, the sameness is boring. Same place, same time, same position.
Well, some people just aren't creative.
And on the other hand, it is possible to take sex too lightly or too seriously. I mean, some people imbue what is essentially a physiological act with a lot of psychological meaning. And for some people, it represents another level of commitment.
Thanks.
Yeah, it was fun.
This weekend was a real bummer.
Don't you know why I love you? Huh? Don't you know why? It's because you're so nice and wonderful. I never thought anybody that was decent would ever look at me more than twice.
What are you saying, that nice girls don't do it?
I'm talking about what we're doing here.
We haven't been doing anything, Harold, if you haven't noticed.
I'm not talking about sex. I'm talking about lying. You're telling your mother one thing and you're doing another. It's dishonest.
So this means that you don't want me to spend the night?
Sex doesn't have to mean commitment, unless you read that into it. I suppose it can be beautiful.
I suppose it can.
But it can also be fun.
Yeah, you're talking to a guy who has nothing against fun.
Well, the reason that I'm not inviting you over to my new apartment tonight...
Your new apartment? You mean to tell me that you're not living with Ma and Pa Kettle anymore?
The reason that I'm not inviting you over to have sex tonight is because I don't know what you'd bring to it. I don't know if you'd want it to be beautiful or fun.
Apple.
It's a jungle.
This guy is a match above your other boyfriends.
Tony Curtis, Jan Michael Vincent, Kim Crosby, Cheetah, and Joe Lara as Tarzan in Manhattan. Next.
Robert Leach, eat your heart out. Come on.